back to the episode of Last Day Out of Survival. Today, we return. We're coming to the shopper real quick just because this dude popped up and I'm like, you know what, let's go here. But welcome to update 1.7.3 out on Android now. We're going to be going over to that hidden garden, paying it a visit, and even check this out. We got a little new tab here called the Raids tab, where you can buy a guest pack, demolishers pack. Demolishers pack, actually, if you want to break in, doesn't. That is only one C4, though. $3. I don't know. That's not what I want to talk about. Right now, I just want to talk about hopefully having these guys come and get eaten alive by zombies. Don't think that's going to happen. So instead, I'm going to take Kalashnikov 47 and bring lots of pain and suffering to these suckers. Let's make sure they were healing during that pain and suffering, too, though. Don't want to accidentally go about dying. Let's see if we can get anything valuable out of here. Then we're gonna go ahead, dine and dash. I'm saying dine and dash, we just stole some beans, so technically, we is dining. We're gonna run out and then see if we can go over to that hidden garden. Bring over the necessities, which is gonna be some seeds and some carrots, both of which we should have. Maybe if we're lucky, we'll get a scuba mask over in one of these. But knowing us, luck is never on our side, so probably not. But I'm so excited, I'm just happy that 1.7.3 ended up coming so quickly after it came out for iOS, which is weird that it came out for iOS first, but whatevs. I'm just happy that the update ended up coming out very close to each other for both Android and iOS, which is awesome sauce. Just like getting this. This is pretty high on the awesome sauceness meter, but let's go ahead, get out of here, see if we can see that event pop up of the hidden garden, because when I was in the overworld, it wasn't popping up originally. But I hope you guys have your favorite fantastic day at the most amazing variety, boys and girls. And today, one of y'all is gonna have an extra fantastic day as we go ahead and announce the winners. That is right, announce the win. Do we have to stop by home before this event unlocks? Because, like, I ain't seeing no hidden garden. I don't know. Maybe I'm crazy, but we're definitely on 1.7.3. But a little bit later in the video, we are going to be announcing the winners of this past week's weekly giveaway. If you guys don't know about that weekly giveaway, every week we do a weekly giveaway here. All you got to do is make sure to hit that like button on a video. Make sure to comment in the video's comment section and make sure that you are subscribed and you'll be entered. And today is the first day y'all can enter in. So make sure to do exactly that. And then when Saturday rolls around, like today, I'll pick a random video from the past week, pick a random comment so y'all can enter in on all future videos, and then I will pick a random comment. If that comment fulfilled everything, that will be the winner that gets announced. Now then, where the hell is this? Like, do we have to stop by home first for this to pop up? Like, I'm just trying to see where this garden's at, because currently it's not popping up, which is odd. I don't know. I feel like maybe we had to, like, go home to trigger it to spawn. And if not, this is going to be really weird, because it definitely... Oh, there we go. There's a red spot in the sky. Someone wants you to find him. And you can see there's 4 days and 4 hours left on this. So a very low amount of time, especially considering that the Chinese New Year isn't until February 16th. It's like February 3rd. I think there's going to be a second and potentially even a third stage to this event. And we'll be talking about why I exactly think that in a sec. But first things first, we got to drop off a couple of these things that we picked up. Run through the base. I did craft up a new chest though to expand our storage a little bit, and let's make sure that we pick up some carrots, pick up some seeds, and we should be able to take things from there. But I'd love to hear how this event has been treating you guys so far. What's the best loot you've gotten from this overall? What you think of in the comment section down below. Also, I can't believe we haven't been raided. That's actually kind of amazing, because it's been a while since the last time we got raided. Like, I ain't complaining. Well, actually I am, because I like going back and getting revenge raids on people. And I moved the next generator into here. Here is the new chest that we stationed. Let's go ahead and make sure that there is a solid amount of room being allocated there. We'll make an actual organization of this eventually. No worries on that front. Although, maybe I will keep these, have those ready to go there. We'll be bringing the AK with us for the challenge, and everything else can go and just hide away for the time being. But I think the AK should be good for that which I seek to do, because Mulan is a little bit of a challenge for us. And actually, I want to bring a couple different weapons and show you guys which weapons maybe are good enough, which weapons aren't good enough for doing this. Melee weapons in general are not going to be good. You'll see what I'm talking about here in a sec. But I'd love to hear how this event is treating y'all in the comment section down below, and that could definitely be your entry into this week giveaway. And today's the first day, and that's where the notification bell comes in handy. That way you don't miss a video, so you know when all the newest news, because I always like to drop the newest informations on y'all as soon as possible. But whatchamacall? Yeah, you can know when those new videos drop, so you can enter in on those and stay as up to date as you can. But for now, I want to stay up to date with the freaking hidden garden, man. Let's go! I'm so excited about this. Oh, what the hell was that? All right, hidden garden, I'm coming. Don't worry, I'm coming. Oh no, I didn't bring the carrot. Okay, I might have some over here in my inbox somewhere. Hopefully, because I totally just left home, and I don't want to have to run back and forth, and also, I don't even know where I would have had that stuff hidden, so, I'll look around a bit. Okay, we got seeds, that's good. Unfortunately, I don't think that I am seeing any carrots, but you know what, for now, we could actually take this opportunity. Listen, we don't have to do the carrot part of this, event right away. Instead, we can focus on the other aspects of it, especially when it comes down to, actually saying hello to Mulan, being like, hello! And doing her little battle. You guys will see what I'm talking about if you don't know yet. So, hey, we cruise on in on the chopper. We got all of these awesome trees. These trees we cannot break into, though. None of these trees can be cut down, I'm pretty sure. Yeah, they're all, like, all sacred and stuff. But these trees are actually really cool. They're all flowered and stuff. What was I gonna say? Let's equip this pistol. We're gonna try and do some of Mulan's quests. I think we have to, hey, Mulan. How you doing? Greetings, stranger. Come with me. Okay. Whatever you say there, Mulan. How do you do? What is up? I see bad guys. Hello, bad guys. This random Jiangshi. All right, why are these dudes just chilling randomly? What the hell? Are they just spread out throughout the map? Oh, and they're smoking out here too. Bad, bad Jiangshi. I think I'm butchering their name too. Bang the gong if you want to compete. Okay, I suppose I could do that. I'm just trying to figure out why they're just like spread out throughout the map or something. I wonder. I'm gonna take these guys out. I want to secure this area, but check out this amazing new map location and these amazing new zombies here. I mean, they're not really too new. They're kind of just a reskin of the Roman zombies, but still, dude, pretty cool if you ask me. Take them out. I wonder if those are the ones they're supposed to spawn in when you like start the battle with her. Maybe, and it all looks like they're dropping stuff, but, I think we have to go and battle Mulan here, so, hello Mulan, I can talk to you, and you can see, I have some tasks for you, help me, and I'll give you something for a turn. Well done, you cope with enemies almost as good as me, almost, why don't we compete someday? So it looks like she had three different tasks for us. The first one was to get rid of the people around the map, so I guess that's what those random ones were. Here we have a little bit of a checklist that we can see. Kill 10 zombies on new Mulan's location. Prepare 10 rice stems on fire. Yo, what the hell? Have you already tried to boil rice? Try once more. You'll get an excellent, nutritious dish. There's a bonfire next to the garden bed, and then will you help me feed the carp? Come closer to the pond. There you'll see a fish feeder. Any seeds will go. So I think yesterday there was also a different set of quests. I think every single day there is a different set of quests that Mulan grants you, because I remember the other day you had to feed carrots to her horse. If you don't know, she has a freaking horse chilling here that potentially might be killable. I don't know, dude. I heard, I think you might be able to use a grenade launcher on it for the sake of science. If you guys want it, it would hurt a lot to use one of my grenade launchers for that, but potentially for the sake of science, it might be done. Here we got the board. That's where you actually can feed him carrots. Here you got something on the other side of the temple. This is why I'm really thinking that there's going to be more to this event, because we have some sort of hidden thing over here in the temple that we do not have access to. Over here, we got some seeds we can plant. That will result in rice stems, which we'll just go ahead and skip ahead on for the time being. Let's make sure that we have enough seeds for what we want to do too. But she said there's a campfire we can use. It's just this cool, awesome little area. And like I said, I really think there's going to be more, because they teased in the dev blog, there was like photos of stuff that aren't here yet. You know, it was like photos of like a couple of treasure chests, kind of like this one down here over in like a wintry type of biome, but those definitely don't exist in this version of the event. And that's why I think there's a timer. I think a new version or something new will come. There was also like a reskinned boss. I think it was like the blind one that was reskinned and had like, I don't know, just had this kind of like Chinese type of oriental, not design, but kind of like attire to it. And it just makes me think that there's more to this event, and people are kind of bummed about it, but for a couple days, we just get free stuff, and you guys can see we can challenge Mulan by hitting the gong. And then she doesn't want us to step outside the circle. We gotta kill these before she does. But you can see she does a lot of damage. So you gotta kill before she can. And you can see it ends up being pretty close. Like a pistol, like, we're kind of, I don't know, because like my dude keeps on shooting to her. Okay, we gotta start shooting this Roman zombie. It's hard because she does so much damage. She does 300 damage and one a hit. So by the time she hits someone, they die right away. And you can see, even doing this with a pistol, not the easiest thing in the world. Because she kills them way before I can. Look at that, man. That's not right. That's not fair. So we might have to take the L on this one. I don't know. We're coming back. Coming back. Oh, please. Oh, no. So close. Super close. Oh, maybe. Nah. Oh, no. No, is there only 20 zombies? Is there more that come? There's more. Oh, terracotta zombie. No. 10 to 12. Oh, this one. That one's definitely living. Oh, got that one before. Okay. She's definitely got that one too late. Oh, no. We're going to the fist. All right. Let's see if we can do the comeback here. No, we can't because that's all the zombies and you can see we lost. So doing it with a pistol, I don't know. If you do it right, I feel like it's possible to do with the pistol, but you have to make sure that like you kind of run to the side where the zombies are coming from, I would say, and then you do have a chance, but a pistol should definitely be possible. Melee weapon, I don't think you can do this with a melee weapon. I'm just being flat out serious here because then she has time to run up and melee them and she does 300 damage. The most melee damage we can do is like 55. Those zombies have 80, so she'll just come in and clean up. So we're gonna see if maybe an M16 will be enough for us to survive. We just gotta make sure that you wanna look on the minimap and you wanna see the direction that the zombies are coming from. And you can see, even using a rifle gets you a pretty great chance at this, but if you know the direction that they're coming from, that gives you a huge advantage because then you can get to them before she has a chance to. See, like, if I was doing this with a pistol, I feel like there'd definitely be hope. Because then we start shooting them a lot further away, which gives us a lot more time to do a lot more damage before Mulan gets over to them. And then she will absolutely murk them. But you can see things are coming up pretty Milhouse here. She might get some. There we go. 13 to 1. You are getting the poo-pooed on. Okay, I'll let you have that one. I ain't getting that one. Oh! I'm getting that one, though. You just want to look at the minimap, and you want to go towards the side of the circle where the zombies are coming from. So that one, I'm not even going to worry about that. I think we won anyways. Yeah, you can see. Take your reward in the chest. Well, how diddly do there, neighbor? Happily, I'll take that. We got the warrior boots, which I don't think they're better than our SWAT boots. They definitely are not better than our SWAT boots, but they are pretty swagalicious. You can see we get some other pretty awesome stuff with it. There's some Bowsy, I don't know how to pronounce that. Steam cooked and stuffed with delicious filling. I think some of these Chinese New Year event items are kind of like Christmas event items where they do have effects, but these don't say what effect they have, so I think we might need to try to figure that out the old-fashioned way. But it's awesome that we got these warrior boots because the armors and weapons that you get from this event, from what Kafir has said, will not despawn, like the Christmas sweater and a couple of the Christmas like ice staff. Yeah, those despawned. They literally went out and said, yeah, you're good to go with the Chinese New Year. So that's pretty awesome. Now, can I bang the gong again or what's up? I think you have to wait. Yeah, you can see I can't bang it. Instead, it looks like we've already defeated me today. Come back tomorrow at the same time. So we gotta wait 24 hours to come back. And that is exactly what we can do over here. That's just a little bit of rope on the Jiangshi. Don't care too much about that. But this is the chest we can open if we do all of her daily tasks. So she said she wanted us to feed the fish. I will feed the fish. Ooh, would you look at that? That was a cool little noise. And now we just need to make rice, I believe, or rice stems on fire. There's a bonfire next to the garden bed. All right, so the garden bed is at this one. I don't see no bonfire. I think you cray-cray, girl. Yeah, I'm not seeing any fire over here. So maybe we have to go somewhere else to, I don't know, begin setting stuff aflame? Because currently, there's not really anything, unless I'm missing, like, the most obvious campfire in the world, my dude. There is not. Oh, there we go. Okay, that's not really by the garden bed. Get out of here. What if you put that in there? You can see that we can get a bowl of rice, which is exactly what she wanted. So we just have to put some type of fuel in this. Currently speaking, we do not have that. So I wonder if any of these guys dropped anything flammable. We're gonna. Is rope flammable? Rope's definitely flammable. Come on. One of these things have to light. And also, I gotta get some food in me, so I kinda wanna finish this rice anyways. We can set rope on fire. Nope. Blech. I might need to go and find some if these guys aren't dropping. They aren't cooperating. If the cloth doesn't set on fire, I've never been this desperate to light a fire. You know? So I've never had to, like, succumb. Okay, yeah, I'm gonna grab some wood. Okay! And with some wood in our inventory, ready and rearing to go, we can actually light that thing and— Oh, what the hell? Ow! I'm dying of thirst! Oh no, oh no, okay, I'm gonna just eat this rice right quick. Oh! Did that give me some thirst? I don't know. Mulan, did I finish your I did! So 10 rice stems? Do you need 10? You need 10 to make a bowl of rice. Okay. Well, I suppose so. But we got a bowl of rice, and I consumed it. Let's complete that quest. And so she gives us a reward by the house. So this reward for defeating her seems to be more of a battle reward. You get kind of like some weapons, some armors, that type of stuff. From what I've seen so far, this is like a resource reward where you can get... Where you can get some pretty good stuff. 6 aluminum bars. I'm taking that to the bank. A first aid kit. I suppose I can take that to the bank, but we'll definitely take some of these. We got some more of the Bowsy over there. We got some more things here that we can grab. We do have a branch spanking reinforced beanie, which actually looks pretty swagalicious with the mask there. Ow, ow, dying of thirst again. Ow, hold on. I got some water, especially for this occasion. And then I'll eat the rest of this food before that goes bad. Drink up an agua. Get us filled up. Sneeze a little bit. Oh, Jesus. I had us too. Woo! And it sneezes like a madman. But, dude, there's this horse here. And, like, I know that, like, I don't know. I think this is a great sign. This is showing that the horse skin, the horse model is in the game. You can see the horse saddle. If you guys don't know, the horse saddle is a craftable recipe that we can't craft yet, but will get unlocked with the Titan Bar, which is the next type of material that should come along with ash planks, I believe, which maybe will come in like update 1.8, because in 1.6, that's when we unlocked oak and steel slash copper. So I can see that happening, but it's awesome to see the horse coming along nicely. The first, the kind of, I think, pond type of situation here. It would have been cool to fish here, but unfortunately we can't. And some new colored trees, although I think they literally just have different colored leaves. I think it's the exact same everything else regarding that. But I really think that maybe, dude, I don't know, maybe the second half of this event, we have to, like, ride the horse to victory over to, like, some second type of area, or we have to do something with this. There's just so many, like, question marks left to this event that there's no way it's going to be over in 4 days. Calling it now. There's the second phase. I think I've heard some people in the community agree with that so far, but from what I'm seeing here, I'm pretty heavily invested in that. So hopefully in a couple of days, we will see things totally revamp. But in the meantime, make sure that you guys are heading over to this event, because it is, like, pretty freaking easy, all things considered. The fighting may be a bit less, but, like, her list of daily tasks, you gotta admit, it's not that bad. Just, like, some carrots, some seeds. Like, sure, we had to wait to get 10 rice stems to cook them up, I guess. But all things considered, I'd say that's more than reasonable. And for some of the reward that we got, like 6 aluminum, some oak logs here, and even like a pretty solid piece of armor. Like, we didn't have a face mask anyway, so perfect for me, you know. And then if you do manage to defeat her, even just bring in like a modified M16, or like I said, dude, if you have a pistol and you actually do my little trick where you run to the side of the circle where the zombies are coming. So if like the zombies are coming from here, you run over here, stay in the circle, and you can start shooting them, because Mulan tends to stay kind of in the middle. So that just kind of buys you a little bit of time. But with that, I think that there's all there is to say about the Chinese New Year event for the time being. But again, by the looks of it, the quests seem to switch up every day, so I'll be taking a peek at those every day. And hopefully within a couple of days, things will change. But I'd love to hear your guys' ideas. And in the comment section, that not only will put you a third of the way into the giveaway, but that could definitely be your entry into the giveaway. It's kind of like giving me your feedback, giving me your thoughts on some of this jazz. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying, dude? Know what I'm saying? I don't know if you know what I'm saying. I think that you do. But another thing that I'm saying is the announcement of Zavinna's of this past week's giveaway. So the randomly chosen video of this past week was when we first got news that update 1.7.3 was coming, like, quote unquote, tomorrow. So this was in Wednesday, the Wednesday Q&A. Kafir said the update was coming Thursday. Got delayed a little bit, but we were talking about that and the rest of the Q&A, which had some pretty juicy information. Huge congrats to the man. Money is my underscore. Number one, I love you, Star. I saw it and I was like, click, click, and click. Well, I'm glad that you literally clicked on my vid 3 times, man. Appreciate that. But congratulations to you, homie, on winning this giveaway. You have been messaged. Check your YouTube inbox. Link to that will be in the pinned comment or in the description. If you don't know how to get there, you should see a message from me. Reply and let me know if you want Android or if you want iOS. And then from there, I will spread some cheer to you with the proper code, and you can put that code to use, especially within the coming days, as we got some of this stuff coming along, dude. We got this whole kind of like guest pack. This is kind of, I don't know, guest pack, like, I guess for a buck, if you have like a buck lying around, it's like, oh, might as well get some iron hatchets, get some coins or something, but I don't know. Yeah, that's pretty poopy. This on the other hand, okay, $3 to get a C4, but that just scares me for the future, because I feel like that means that these packs over here, the Armageddon and Quick Mop-Up, dude, these things give you 3 C4 a pop. I'm just saying, those are probably gonna be like $10 or something, because here you get 1 C4 and 2 iron hatchets for like $3, and here you can see they value iron hatchets at right around $1, because 50 coins is like, I don't know, let's just do some quick math. 50 coins, oh, what the hell, 58 coins? Why does everything have an 8 at the end? This is weird. Does that have something to do with like Chinese New Year? Or is this just like some kind of random glitch where zeros became 8s? I don't know, I'm a little bit clueless on that front. But you can see they value iron hatchets, 2 of them, at around $1, because you can get, well actually, I mean 50 coins is $2, that's kind of a good deal anyway, but here, you can see adding a C4 to the mix for an additional $2 to make that 3 C4 and a better weapon. I can definitely see that approaching like 7, 8, maybe even $10. Even with this one, dude, because this is the perfect weapon for raids, because it's silenced. This is the go-to raiding pack. The shotgun, I don't know who in their right minds would bring a shotgun to a raid, but potentially someone not so much in their right mind, which means it's totally something that I would do so far from experience. But why don't we go and try to signal up a raid? Well, actually, I'm a little bit skeptical to start the raid. Instead, why don't we head on over to the bunker and open up some stuff? Because I've heard reports of people saying that the raids have been glitchy for them or something along those lines. I don't know if glitchy is the right word, but apparently some people get stuck into like a 95% loading glitch after they perform a raid or something like that. So I'm going to be a little bit cautious on that front. And instead, we're just going to bring an absolute poop ton of tickets, go and open up some of the usual, and we are like 3 red tickets away, which is freaking, dude, we're so close, man. And I'll just toss out this a couple of these random one things here, since we're not going to be putting these to too much use. And I mean, I should have just put that cigarette away. It's like one pack, it's nothing too crazy, but that heights a little bit. Let's start heading on over there. Maybe if we're lucky, we'll get our hands on those 3 combat gear that we need, but otherwise, hopefully within the next raid, we'll be good to go. But you can see we have upgraded this room to now have 3 generators. That room has the power output of insanity. It's a lot of power. That's the only way a man's can really put it. I can put all that stuff away. All right, that's pretty full. We don't have any extra red tickets from there. Let's head on over to the bunker and let's see what goods lie in there. And the fact that nothing's been stolen from our bunker floor, so I think it is pretty safe to assume. From what I've heard, as long as you give the raiders, if you are doing raiding, as long as you give them their fair share, all of your loot in other bases and in the bunker is safe, at least for the time being. Because the way that Kefir made it sound, they made it seem like with this update, everyone would lose all their stuff in the bunker. Not this update, but like 1.7.2. You know, a while back, they made it sound like anything at the bunker was about to be nada, about to be absolutely tootalootly gone. And you know what, we'll just drive on over here. But that has been the case so far, which is amazing news for us, because we're dinguses who store stuff there. So, yeah. Anyways, while we head on into here, it's also gonna be a great opportunity for us to talk about the code. Reminder though, the code that I enter might expire by the time you're watching this video, so hopefully someone in the comments will post the updated code or something, because we do have a pretty freaking awesome community here, and y'all, at least from what I've seen when I read the comments, which I love to do, is just the helpfulness and the awesomeness and the fact that y'all really are living that philosophy of fan-freaking-tasticness, of positivity, and honestly, I just appreciate it a whole ton. I don't know, I just love seeing positivity, seeing y'all being so happy, so go-lucky, so positive with each other. Although it does suck when we got some poopy things occur. Like, for example, the loot me glitch and those things happen. That is quite painful. But today's code is 789. No, not 9, 290. Got that a little bit mixed up. That'll let it open. People tell me, why do I usually wait until the elevator's all the way up before I enter the bunker? It just feels right. I know I can enter it like I just did there as soon as I enter the code, but it doesn't feel right. You know, I don't want to like make it seem like I'm dolphin diving in the elevator as it's barely opening up. Like I like just giving it a sec. I like waiting until it's fully up. Because it's just realistic that way, man. It's all about the realism, all right? Now get over here, zombie. I gotta shoot you in the face with my M16. But it's all about the realism. You know what I mean? And we just gotta mow down a couple of these puppies. Honestly, should probably just be using the pistol at this point. But let's open up a couple of these terminals. Let's see if the goodies are as good as they could be, and no whammy, no whammy, no whammy. No whammy. Thank you for the engine part. Appreciate you a whole ton there, lad. Appreciate that a ton because I love the engine part stockpile we got going on. And another one for the stockpile along with two M16s. More medical supplies. I'd say that is a pretty freaking awesome opening at the end to leave things off on. But with that, I actually gotta head on out a little bit. Sorry that the video's a little bit shorter, but I do want to play it safe with raids because I have heard they are glitchy. Let me know in the comment section if you guys do decide to risk it for the biscuit, go for the raid. Let me know if the game ends up glitching or anything like that, because I've heard some people say that it's fixed, some people say that it's not fixed, so I don't know. I'm kind of gonna hopefully play it by ear, and I just don't want to get my account stuck in 95%, you know what I'm saying? So I'm just being overly on the safe side. It's better to be more safe than more sorry, you know what I mean? But I'd love to hear that, and just overall, I'd love to hear the fact that y'all are having a fan-freaking-tastic day. But that's gonna go ahead and wrap it up for us for now, because I do need to go run to the library and start working on my homework, because this semester sucks, and I'm taking the hardest class I've yet taken in college, which is a huge struggle. But YOLO, hopefully 3 videos going up today. Hope you guys enjoy those. That's right, I'm a madman. But that's gonna go ahead and wrap up for me for now. Can't wait to hear what you guys gotta say in the comment section down below about the update. Best of luck in the new weekly giveaway. Congrats to the winner of this past giveaway. Check your messages, and I'll make sure to reply to my message. And overall, just have yourselves a fan-freaking-tastic day. Best of luck in your raids. Best of luck with the Chinese New Year event. Best of luck with the raid defense. Best of luck in you guys are chopper, and best of luck having an absolutely never saying that word again fan-freaking-tastic day. Thank you guys for watching. Have yourselves an awesome one, and I'll talk to you next one. See ya.